Internal Revenue Service today revoked the tax-exempt status of the PTL. Production of the Dodge, Aries, and Plymouth Reliant from Detroit to Mexico. The transfer this summer means...
And those new beds where they're putting in the basement. It's not quite finished, but as you can see, they sort of leaning toward washing and drying clothes and easy access for anyone up in years.
As a
some services put up a warning, many others don't.
Outside entrance, rear patio.
With that message,
this garage differs from mine, only in that I could get my car into a part of our garage. I don't think the car's ever been in this garage. There's our upper patio that's got the hot tub. There's you know what. And there's the sweep of the drive coming back into the garage. Doing his thing with the basketball. Fancy stuff. There's a drive going back inside of the house. There's a good shot of the front of the house. Van, a shot of the neighborhood or street. You see the blossoms out on the trees, and it's a little spring-like.
It's a cherry cinema, very dangerous.
Fine.
6 minutes to dinner.
I could use it.
Here he comes. Say some dirty words. Just mouth some dirty words.
There's the kitchen.
Oh, he didn't take a picture.
Oh, he's our insurance man. Our insurance man is here, look.
Oh, don't come in if you don't want him to take your picture.
Oh, yeah.
You know this girl here. Say hi.
Hi.
How are you feeling?
Very well.
Just got a picture of this La Bamba down here. Lift your...
No, only side views.
This is La Bamba.
I thought you meant Jerry Curry was here.
This is the upper patio. Little table. View of the backyards.
Is this your grandma Diodaria production?
Yep.
Josh, you want to shoot some baskets and have Papa take your picture?
I got a couple.
You already got them? Did you get them from the $50 seats? This is the hot tub.
The hot tub.
This is to get rid of people's aches and pains. You get in here and it's 104 degrees. You turn this on, it swirls the water. Makes you feel good.
Justice and a friend of his acting like little boys. This is the princess's bedroom. And you notice she keeps it real neat. No, she keeps her closet all shaped up nice and neat all the time.
Oh, brother.
And you know who this belongs to?
What?
This new crib.
There's a Senate thing on the wall. I was paying
for a seat. All set for new tenants. Louise will kill me when she sees the pictures of her bedroom.
No, she won't. You got enough light?
Yeah. Trying to stay away from the window light. Really.
I think it's done.
And she's got a window looking out the back. And there's her bathroom. This is the main floor bathroom.
Getting the
teach his little apprentice how to cook and prepare supper.
No, I didn't have any.
There's a refrigerator board.
Just, I didn't put yours, any garlic on yours or cheese.
Motherly duties of cleaning shoes. I just went through the farmer's barn.
Lou, do you want to bring me some plates and I'll load them up?
Yeah.
The side of the house. In the back, we're going to try to pick up Justice sliding down his special pole here. Okay, you just watch what you're going to do. Watch what you're doing. All right. Of course, you've got to try something different, too, you know.
Camera broke.
What's going to be happening today, Just? Huh? Your what? First communion? Boy, that's all right. I think you'll be able to handle it all right.
Come on, walk in with your brother. Get your picture taken.
Well, you can stand up because you can get moved.
For yourself.
I'm pretty.
She's also very humble.
Yeah. All right, get up. Nice. That ought to be a pretty good shot.
Did you just leave it a little bit open?
I didn't close it.
You're
gonna be in movie pictures.
I know, isn't that great?
Take your picture.
You have a good trip.
John, it was great. We had a very, very nice visit with my cousin in Columbus.
Oh, oh good.
That was
don't
nice.
Say any bad word because he has sound.
He has sound.
That's what that's for.
So there's bread until somebody takes bread and puts it on the table. What else do we need? Yes. We need people. We can't have mass without people. You can't have just a priest go up by himself. There have to be other people too. What else do we need? We need wine. We can't have a mass unless someone's going to bring wine and put it on the table. What else do we need? Lots of answers. We need a priest, thank you. Thank you for remembering. We need a priest to help us all pray together. All right, so you're thinking of even more things. We need to have love. We're going to ask, we're going to see in a minute what we need to have in our hearts when we come, okay? Good. What else? Can you think of anything else? All right, we need to have praise in our hearts. Is there anything, any other stuff that we need? Or is that pretty well all the stuff we need? Is there any more stuff that we need? Those are the main ones. We need a church. Most of the time we need a church. On special occasions, you can go outside. Sometimes on special occasions, you would actually be able to have a mass outside. But most of the time, we're in a church together. Is there any stuff that we need? What? Very good. Good for you. We need to have our readings from the scriptures, from the Bible. We have to listen to that, because that's God truly speaking to us. One more hand is up. We need holy water. We had holy water today, didn't we? Because that's a reminder of the day we were baptized. I think we're running out of the things we need. Well, okay, we have something for the wine to be in. One more. We have a cross. Every church should have a cross. So those are the things we need. Now, what do we need to have in our hearts when we come to Mass? And you said, first of all, we have to have love in our hearts when we come to Mass. We have to have a desire to love each other who are in our church together. And what else do we need to have in our hearts for us to be able to have a celebration of Mass together? Yes. Hope, love, and hope. Now, what is the third one that we need to have when we come together and have our Mass together? Okay. All of you know. Who didn't get an answer? Who didn't get a chance yet? Who didn't get a chance yet? Did you get a chance yet? Love and hope and faith. We have to have faith, especially for our Mass. We have to have faith. Believe. We have to have our true faith that Jesus is really here. That's what we heard in our reading today. That this is really the body of Jesus. This is really his blood. And we have that faith when we hear that story told again in the prayer that the priest says, we all have to be believing in that and knowing that we can trust and hope and believe in Jesus' promise that he'll be with us when we have our faith shared together. All right, one more set of questions. You're doing great. You're showing that you really understand our celebration today. Where do we get our faith? Where does our faith come from? Okay, from Jesus. Always faith comes from the Lord. But how did he get it from him to you? What? Sorry? Good enough. You're right. Our faith is always a gift from Jesus. We never just make this up. It always comes from Jesus. But how did he get it to be in your heart in order to be ready for today?
How did that happen?
Oh, I see. There's a hand up. All right. What now? From your mom and dad. Where does faith come from? From your family. From their believing, then you learn to believe. You receive your gift of faith in Jesus through your family's faith. Where else did you have your faith that helped you be here today? Guys, I know you'll think of this. Who else helped you to understand all about communion so that you could come and celebrate today? Yes. Yes. From your teachers, in a special way, your teachers too helped you to have your faith to know the stories of what Jesus did and to know the story of how he had a special meal with his apostles. And so all of your family, but especially your mom and dad, helped you to have that faith. Your teachers and all of your other friends and classmates in school and in your Sunday classes helped you to have your faith, to believe in Jesus. And so they're very proud of you today. Did you get the idea a little bit by everything that your moms and dads are doing that they're a little bit proud of you today? Did you get that idea? I think so. I think you can tell. Your teachers are sitting way in the back. They're very proud of you today. And you know what? We're very proud of all them, too. We're very proud of the fact that they have helped you to grow up knowing that the Father loves you and that Jesus did those things for us. We're very proud of them. And they have helped you to grow up so that today you believe that Jesus is truly with us. We're proud of your parents for making that family of faith. For you to be people with faith. We're very proud of your teachers for taking on whole big groups of you, 20 or 30 at a time. But they were able to be your teachers and to help you to grow in faith. Now what we do is we celebrate and share with each other the faith that we have. We know that Jesus promised that he will be with us. It all comes from Jesus. We know that we could never make it up. It all is this great and wonderful blessing that comes from him. But we also have to remember that the way he sent it to us, through all the people who love us and who take good care of us. So as I say, we're very proud of you all who are receiving your first communion today. But before we finish, we have to think of a way to thank our moms and dads. How many are grandparents here today? Raise your hands. Look at all the grandmas and grandpas here today. We thank them for the way that they have been able to help you have your faith. How are we going to thank all of our moms, all the dads, all the grandmas and grandpas, all the teachers who are here who helped you to be ready to have the faith for this day? How can we do that? How can the parents thank the teachers? How can the teachers thank the parents and everyone else? How can we do that right now? Yes. Shake hands, we can do even better than that. Can't we? Let's thank each other today. Well done.
Complain. Rebecca. You gonna talk to me? Tell me a big story. You got a big cough, don't you? Rebecca?
Yeah.
Hiya. Uh-oh.
You can go back next to Jean, Andrew, so Rebecca can see both of you. Say hi to her, Andrew.
Hi, Rebecca Jean, you're our beautiful sister. Jesus, you were born
on December 25th. No, whose birthday is December 25th?
Jesus.
Right, so whose birthday is December 21st? Andrew's, right. Are you going to have a birthday, Andrew?
And then he's going to have a birthday, then Daddy and me is going to have a birthday, and then it's your birthday.
No, you say Daddy and I are going to have a birthday.
Daddy and I are going to have a birthday, and then Grandma's
going to
have a birthday.
And when was Rebecca Jean born?
October
what?
October 21st.
Correct. Very good. Rebecca Jean, can you smile for us?
Your birthday is October 21st.
She's looking right at you, Gina. She loves you.
Hi, this is your little brother. You're my little sister, and you're my little brother. This is your little brother, and I'm your big sister, and you're the little one. You're the littlest. You're the littlest. He's the littlest. He's the largest. Big boy.
Don't do that, please.
Okay.
Gee, Andrew, don't do it. If I tell Gina, that means you too.
Oh, Rebecca. Bumdy, 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 bumdy. Try to sing it.
She wants to do it, Gina.
They're all copying me. See, they copying me. If I play with them.
What does Daddy say to you, Andrew, when he does that? What does he say? Put them up.
You know what? If they see me do.
If they what?
If I'm playing with my brother and sister and they see me do something good, then if she and him, then they'll copy me and do the same thing. They'll do what I do. What they see what I do, they'll do what I do.
Right.
If all of us do good, then we.
I think she
and
wants.
Savior,
right.
Grow up in heaven.
Very good.
Yes.
Yes.
We have a supper.
I think she wants to talk to you, Gina.
She's so excited. She's so excited that I'm here. She's excited that she was born to us because she thought